Hey guys, this is Siddhi from Best of Beauty and welcome back to my channel. So as you all can see that I'm really really excited for today's video, and that's because it's a cult beauty haul video. Now if you don't know, Cult Beauty has to be one of my favorite international websites to shop from. They have so many brands, you name it, they have it. They have NARS, they have Hourglass, they have Laura Mercier, they have Ordinary, and I just feel like, you know, they have everything that you need. And today I'm actually going to take you through all of the products that I recently purchased from their website, and I'm obviously going to take you through the entire process as well as to how I shopped, then the customs duty, and also how many days it took, and all of the information I'm going to give you in this video. So I really hope that you enjoy it. So without any further ado, let's just get started. But before that, if you are new to my channel or if you haven't subscribed already, then please hit on the red subscribe button and turn on the notifications so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. And also, if you don't follow me on Instagram, make sure you do. I'm gonna obviously leave all the handle details on the screen because I do tutorials on there like on a day-to-day basis, so you should definitely check it out. And yeah, let's just get started. So when I decide that, you know, I want to shop from Cult, I usually first gravitate towards the skincare because I personally feel that there are not too many good skincare brands that are available in India. So I personally love first shopping for skincare and then I move on to makeup. So first let's talk about skincare. So the first product that I got is actually the Herbivore Prism Exfoliating Glow Serum, and this is what it looks like. I'm obviously going to leave a picture of it on the screen as well so you all can see exactly how the product is, and I really wanted to try it out because obviously it's a glow serum. So this particular serum has a lot of great ingredients in it. It has lactic acid, it has glycolic acid, it has willow bark, aloe vera and rose water. So all of this is going to exfoliate your skin really well and, you know, give you like smooth and glowing skin. So I was really excited to get my hands on this, and I personally am not using a lot of serums right now, so I thought that I should give this a go. And the packaging on this is so pretty. Just look at this. I don't know if you can tell, but it's like almost like a holographic packaging and it's so pretty. So that was the first skincare product that I got, and now let's move on to the second one. And this one is the Caudalie Vino Perfect Radiant Serum Complexion Correcting. Now the reason I wanted to get this one is obviously, again, it's supposed to give you that radiance and bright looking skin, and this serum you can use on a day-to-day basis as well, and it's not as exfoliating as compared to the earlier serum that I showed you. And this is also supposed to be like a really really good serum if you have dark spots, to prevent them, and also if you already have dark spots, then to reduce you know, the appearance as well. So that's why I wanted to try this out. And what they have also mentioned is that this is 62 times more effective than vitamin C at boosting radiance and evening out complexion as well. And this is suitable for all skin types, and it reduces dark spots and pregnancy marks, acne marks, sun pigmentation and age related dark spots as well. So that's why I'm really really excited to try this out, and I'm obviously going to be using this on a day to day basis, and I'll let you know if it actually works or not. Not that I have a lot of dark spots on my face, but just evening out your skin tone, I think that this is definitely going to help, and I have high hopes for this. And this is how the packaging looks like up close. So those were the two serums that I got. Now let's move on to the third product, which is actually a lip care product, and this one is by Lano Lips. Now I've again heard great reviews about Lano Lips and their lip balms as well, and this one is actually their Baby Rose Gold you know, ointment, which can be used on the lips as well as your cheeks, and this has like a beautiful, you know, shine to it as well, and I'm excited to try this out. And this is actually 97.7% natural, which is great. So I'm just going to open this up for you and show you the packaging. It's actually really really cute if you can see. So this is what the product looks like, and as you can see that this has like a really nice sheen to it, and it actually has like rose gold flecks in it as well. The fourth product that I got is actually a hair care product. Now I personally don't buy a lot of hair care products because I feel like it's very tricky to find the right, you know, a product for my hair, because as you can see that they're really fine and I have really oily scalp and have dry ends, and you know, it's just a big mess. So finding the right products is very very difficult, but I really was excited to try this out because again, I've heard like great things about this. and this one is by Color Wow. So this is actually called as a dream coat, and this is a supernatural hair spray. Now what this does is it's supposed to reduce all of the hair frizz, and it gives you like the most beautiful silky shiny hair and sleek hair as well. And you know, I don't know if you all know the trend of glass hair. I'm just going to leave a picture so you all can see. So this is supposed to give you that glass hair as well. So I'm really excited to try this out because my hair is so frizzy because of this weather, and there is literally nothing that can, you know, help to tame it down. Now let's move on to the makeup products that I got. Now first, whenever I go shopping on the website, I always gravitate towards concealers for some odd reason. I just like holding on concealers, and I think I'm obsessed to with them on another level. So I had to get my hands on this, and this is the Hourglass Vanish Airbrush Concealer. Now I've heard again such great reviews about this concealer, so this is what that one looks like. So this one is in the shade Beach. Now I do feel from the packaging that this is definitely going to be lighter for my skin, but when I was shopping, they actually recommended, you know, for me to go for this shade because I know the shade in my Hourglass foundation. So they recommended, you know, me to go for this particular shade as well, but I think that this is going to be light. I'm just going to swatch this for you on my hand so y'all can see how it looks like. The consistency of this is just so beautiful, and it's so lightweight. And just look at the pigment. Like, it still has a lot of pigment, as you can see when I'm blending it on my skin as well. So I don't think that you're going to need a lot of product, and it's definitely going to be blending really nicely onto the skin as well. The next product is actually a blush. Now it's unlike me to, you know, shop for blushes, but this is that product which I kept adding to my cart and I kept deleting it, you know, for all of the times that I've shopped on their website. But this time I thought that I should just give it a go because I don't have a lot of blushes. I prefer, you know, using cream blushes rather than using powder blushes on my skin. So this one is the Laura Mercier blush, and I actually don't have, I have only one Laura Mercier product. I don't have, you know, a lot of their products, so I wanted to give this a go. And this is what the packaging looks like. It's super cute, and it's obviously luxe as well. I'm just going to open it up and show you the shade. So it has a mirror, and then this is what this shade looks like. It's a beautiful rosy pink shade, and obviously this is going to complement my skin really well as well. So I'm excited to try this out. So those were all of the things that I got from Cult Beauty, and because I got all of those things, I had an option of selecting two samples. So the first sample that I selected is this right here, and I'm so excited for this. This is the Dr. Barbara Sturm face cream. Now if you all don't know, Dr. Barbara Sturm's products are used by all of the international celebrities out there. I see them using her skincare products, and I really wanted to give them a go, but her products are super expensive. All of them are like $100 to $200 above, like each product. So obviously I'm never going to get the full size, so I'm excited to try out this sample. And this is actually her face cream, which is supposed to be really rich and creamy and hydrating. So I'm excited for this. And the next sample that I got is from Wishful, and this is their YoGlow Enzyme Scrub. Now I was going to get the full size of this, but then I thought that I already have so many exfoliating and, you know, like scrubs anyway. So I thought that I should try out this sample first and see if it actually works for my skin or not. So this is a sample of that. So yeah guys, that is it for the haul. I really hope that you enjoyed it as well. I just thought that I should sit down and film a video for you guys and just like casually talk about all of the products that I got. And now let's move on to my entire experience from shopping on their website to customs and the delivery time and all of that. So I have personally shopped from Cult Beauty over 10 times till now, so I know how things work. So obviously you go on their website, I'm going to leave a link to it in the description box as well. You click on it, then you shop whatever you want, and then you have obviously the checkout page wherein you enter all of your details, you enter your address and all of that. And then the delivery options are obviously, there are two options that they give you guys. So if you shop over a certain amount, the international shipping is free. I think the amount keeps varying, but I think it's around £50 or so. So if you shop above £50, then the international shipping is going to be free, and that's going to be your standard international shipping. So that obviously takes a lot of time to come, and there is no like exact tracking of where your package is, because you know they're just going to send the product and then it's going to be with the customs, and then you don't know exactly when you're going to get the parcel. So when I've opted for the standard shipping, it has taken me from, sometimes it has come within 10 days, but sometimes it has also taken a month to come. So it all depends on how the customs in your particular city is going to be like and how quick they are with their services. Now the second delivery option is wherein you opt for the priority shipping, which is delivered by DHL. So obviously you can track exactly where your package is from day one till it gets delivered to you. But obviously because it's priority shipping, they do charge you extra as well. They I think charge you around 30 to 35 pounds extra if you want to get the priority shipping option. And when you opt for that, the package gets delivered to you within a week. So this time I opted for priority shipping, and here is my experience. So the reason I opted for priority shipping in the first place is because of the lockdown. Things are getting delayed and the customs in Mumbai is really slow, and you know I was really worried that I might not get the parcel. I'm obviously spending so much money, so I wanted everything to come to me safely and in time. So that's why I opted for priority shipping, and I thought that DHL is obviously a very well renowned company, so I'm going to get everything in time and everything is going to be well tracked as well. But sadly, here is my experience with it. Now I was obviously hoping that the parcel is going to get delivered to me within that time period, because obviously when you're opting for priority shipping, they ensure that you know your parcel gets delivered at that exact time. So it actually took the parcel 19 days to get delivered to my house, even though I had opted for priority shipping and even though I had paid extra money for it. Now I'll tell you why all of this happened. So the parcel was actually, you know, in Mumbai in like 5 days, okay, but the parcel was stuck with customs for the rest of the day. So the parcel was just there in Mumbai and you know it wasn't getting delivered to me via DHL. Now the problem with that is, so DHL obviously calls me saying that obviously ma'am, your parcel has been, you know, like delivered to India, and you know, but here's the issue, the parcel has come in courier mode, and because it's cosmetics, the customs department is not going to be processing and you know allowing your parcel to get delivered to you because it has come in courier mode. And they said that the parcel has to be transferred from the courier mode to the cargo mode, because through cargo all of these cosmetic products can be delivered to you. And here's what I was thinking at that point, that if DHL knows that cosmetic products cannot be brought into the country via courier mode and they have to be brought via cargo mode, why are you getting it through the courier mode anyway? Like, how does it make sense? You have to figure your system out and you have to ensure that the customer is getting the product at the right time and there is no hassle. So I do ask them all of these things, and they are telling me that ma'am, you are not supposed to order cosmetic products in you know, because there are a lot of new restrictions that have been put on them. So I am like, okay, I obviously had no idea about this, but I will obviously be more careful. Now what's the next step? So they are like, ma'am, so now the parcel has to be transferred from the courier mode to the cargo mode, and you know, we'll be needing a lot of like extra documents for it. So I'm like, okay, tell me what all documents do you need. Now the document list that they sent me was not like a regular document, you know, wherein they'll ask you for your PAN card or they'll ask you for, you know, just the invoice of the product that you got. It was so complicated, and all of this took so much time, and I had to keep following up with the DHL, you know, customs agent as well, as to where is my product, what is happening, and it was just so tedious. And today the parcel comes. Today is the day when I actually received the parcel, so I thought that I should just sit down and just like shoot this video and vent everything out and give you guys the entire, you know, experience as well. So the person who's delivering calls me and he's like, ma'am, I have your DHL parcel and you know you have to pay the customs duty. So then I'm like, okay, what's the amount? And then he's like, 18,000. I'm like, what? 18,000. And when he said 18,000, I was just like, wow, like this is the biggest mistake that I've ever ever done, and I regretted so much. Like when he handed over the parcel also to me, I was just like, it's so not worth it. Like, it's just so not worth it. If I could just give this parcel back and get a refund and not pay anything extra, that would just be ideal at this point. And this is not the first time this has happened with me, actually. This is happening for the second time, but I had ordered from a completely different website, so I had not expected the same thing to happen, especially through Cult Beauty. But the common factor was actually DHL. So if you ever come across DHL as the shipping, you know, agent or shipping company, do not buy the products. Just do not. The entire experience was so miserable. And the reason why customs also charged me so much is because it was transferred from the courier mode to the cargo mode. And then obviously the parcel stayed, you know, with them for so many days. So they were obviously charging me for that as well, which is just not my fault. So I was paying for something that was not my fault at all. So yeah guys, that is it for today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it and you found it informative. And if you all still have any queries with respect to anything, just leave them in the comments down below, because I would love to answer them and help you as well, so that you don't go through all of this mess like I did, because I honestly regretted so much wasting so much money on these products. It's really, really not worth it. And yeah, if you did like this video, then make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and share it with your friends, because you definitely need to warn more people about what's happening, because this has not happened with me once. It has happened before as well. So, you know, if I would really appreciate if you share this video so that other people don't go through this. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Love you.